Instructor, and today I'm going to be showing you how to cook a delicious lamb stew in your slow cooker. The options for the meat in the stew are going to be a whole shoulder, which you can purchase and cut yourself, which is quite easy, or you can purchase it pre-cut into stew meat. So let's get cooking. We're going to prep the chard by taking the leaves off of the stems, because what we're going to do is saute the stems with the onion, and then we're going to wilt the leaves in later at the end. Chop up the stems, as we're gonna make them in about 1-inch pieces. Before we put the stew into the slow cooker, we're actually gonna brown the lamb first, because that will develop a really rich flavor in the finished stew. So we're gonna begin with the heat on medium high. We really want a hot pan to get a nice crust on the outside of the meat. We'll begin with 2 tablespoons of olive oil. Add the meat all in one layer to the pan. Adding salt at this point will allow the meat to be seasoned all the way through rather than just on the outside. And this will probably take about 15 minutes to get a nice crust. So every once in a while, give it a stir. You can see that we're already starting to get some nice browning. At first, the meat's gonna release juices. As those evaporate, that's when you're gonna start seeing the browning. That's also when the flavor is really starting to develop. At this point, I'm gonna transfer the meat to the slow cooker. I'm gonna try to reserve as much of the fat in the pan as I can, because we're gonna use that neck to saute the onions and the chard. I'm gonna reduce the heat to medium and get the vegetables in the pan. Adding the vegetables to the pan at this point is gonna pick up all those nice brown bits at the bottom. We've got the onion, the Swiss chard stems, some garlic. We're gonna saute this until it's a little bit tender, has nice browning on the outside, and picks up all that flavor, which will take about 3 to 5 minutes. We'll add in the cardamom. We'll also throw in a little bit of pepper. By adding it to the pan now, we're toasting the spices, which really brings out their full flavor. I don't want to ignore all of this flavor that's still left clinging to the bottom of the pan, so I'm going to deglaze it with a little bit of water. And then just scrape it all off the bottom and add this to the slow cooker too. Lamb shoulder actually prefers to be braised. It's got a lot of connective tissue and is one of the less tender cuts of lamb, but it's actually one of the most flavorful too. That said, you could do this in your oven at about 300 degrees for 3 to 4 hours. We'll add the rest of the ingredients. Bay leaf, the cinnamon, 2 cloves, butternut squash, and now we'll add the apple cider. So now we're gonna give it a good stir and then set the timer to 6 to 8 hours and the setting to low. So the super cool thing about this recipe is that now you can just set it and forget it. It's been about 6 hours, so let's take a look at the stew. Oh my gosh, it smells amazing. Just gonna take out one piece and set it on the cutting board. And we should be able to easily shred it with 2 forks. Oh my gosh, look at that. Amazing. I'd say that's done. So now I'm just gonna finish the stew with some chopped chard leaves. This is from the stems that went in earlier. I'm just gonna roughly chop it. And the heat of the stew is gonna cook that. It also adds a beautiful bright green color, some freshness, and lots of nutrition. And let that cook for about 5 to 10 more minutes. Now that the chard is melted in, I'm ready to eat. The finishing touch is gonna be a bright hit of flavor from yogurt, and also a little bit of chopped fresh cilantro. And there you have it, a hearty one-pot meal.